Hello everyone, I am Mr. D. J. Doshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we will be studying about the problem related to projection of solids. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the projections of the solids as per given conditions. Now this is called a tetrahedron. So what is tetrahedron? First, so tetrahedron is a solid of which all the four faces are equilateral triangle. So this is nothing but a pyramid of triangular base, that is triangular base pyramid or triangular pyramid, of which all the faces, that is 3 plus 1, 4 faces will be equilateral triangles. So let us read the problem. A tetrahedron of 45 mm side has one of its edge in HP and inclined at 45 degree to VP. The triangular place contained by the edge of a base in the HP is perpendicular to the HP. Draw its projections. So one by one we will start. First thing, it is a tetrahedron of 45 mm side base. So all the sides will be of 45 mm. One of its edge is in HP. So edge is in HP. If you observe the tetrahedron, its top view will be of course a equilateral triangle with apex O joined with 1, 2, 3. That is 1, 2, 3 is a triangle which is equilateral triangle of 45 mm side, and O1, O2 and O3 will be the generators which will be shown by the dark line. Now the condition is that its base is in HP. So now what is the base edge? 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 1 are the base edges. Out of that, one edge should be in HP. So you have to draw the equilateral triangle in such a way that 2, 3 will be towards your right hand side and it will be perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP or resting on HP. So draw equilateral triangle in the top view in such a way that 1, 2, 3 is equilateral triangle and 2, 3 will be perpendicular to VP. Okay. Now project upwards, projected 1 upwards, so give it as a 1 dash, and project 2, 3 upwards, so it will be 2 dash, 3 dash. O is the apex which is at the center of the equilateral triangle. Now project it upwards, you will get O, O dash. So extend it upwards. Now see, O1, O2 and O3 are the generators of the tetrahedron. Out of that, if you observe, O1 is parallel to XY line or parallel to VP. So now as O1 is parallel, its front view projected upwards will be a true length line. As we know the basic thing that if one of the view is parallel to one of the plane, it will be viewed in another plane as a true length line. So O1 in the top view is parallel to XY line or parallel to the plane. So project 1 upwards and O upwards and O upwards. Now 1O will be 45 degrees. So take 1 as a center and with compass and length equal to true length, that is 45 mm, mark the apex as 45 degree on the projection of O. So you will get the O dash point. So O dash 1 dash will be equal to 45 degree and join O dash 2 dash and O dash 3 dash. Of course 2 dash 3 dash will be a point view of a line 2, 3, that is base edge which is resting on HP. So you will get a triangle of which O dash 1 dash will be true length line, O dash, O dash 2 dash and O dash 3 dash, which is the same line, is the apparent length of the generator O2 and O3. Now complete this projection. Later on what is given? A tetrahedron of 45 mm side has one of its edge in HP and inclined at 45 degree VP. So VP we will be drawing later on. The angle with VP we will be drawing in the third stage. Now what is the next step given? That the base edge containing that H in HP is perpendicular to HP. So now, what is the base edge joining to apex is O2 or O3 dash, which is a line. So it should be perpendicular to HP. So we will rotate this front view triangle in such a way that the line O2 or O3 which is the same line perpendicular to HP. So rotate. Now see, if you observe, this is the view and this is the face O2, O2, O dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, and this has to be perpendicular to HP. So I have rotated in clockwise direction in such a way that O dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, which is a line view or edge view of a triangle, so it will be perpendicular to HP, and redraw this. So first draw O dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, mark O dash, from there mark, take the distance 45 mm, that is O dash, 1 dash, and take the base distance with the compass at 2 dash 3 dash, mark here, join 1 dash 2 dash 3 dash and 1 dash 4 dash, and of course the axis will be drawn here. So now from this we will observe that the triangular place face contained by the edge of the base in the HP is perpendicular to HP. So now this is the face O2, O dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, which is containing the base edge 2 dash 3 dash is perpendicular to HP, and we have redrawn this. Now project it upwards, so O dash, 2 dash and 3 dash are on the same projector, project it downer, project 3 horizontally you will get 0.3, project O horizontally you will get 0.0 here, and project 2 and vertically 2 you will get 0.2. Now here we have 1, so 1 we will project it downwards. 1 project it horizontally, you will get 0.1. So join 1 3 1 2 and 1 0. So this is the top view of the second stage when the face containing that base edge is perpendicular to HP. So this is the face containing that edge, that is base edge, is perpendicular to HP. Now next part, that is inclined to 45 degree to VP. So now as this is the point view of line 2, 3. So this will be of course a true length line. We have already drawn the equilateral triangle in the first stage. Same is projected here. So 2, O dash 3 will be a true length line. That is edge view of the base, you can say. So now what is given? It is inclined at 45 degree to VP. So draw a 45 degree line on this, making 45 degree with XY line. On that, take certain point 3 away from the plane and join 3O2, which is of course of the same length, and redraw the triangle 3, 1, 2, 3 and mark 1O. So this is the plane, top view of the plane, making rotated in such a way that the base edge, edge view of the base is making 45 degree with VP. So this is a 45 degree line on which we have completed the top view of the second stage. Now project 1 upwards, project horizontally 1 dash, you will get 0.1. Project 3 upwards, horizontally of course 3 will be on the base, and project 2 upwards you will get 2 dash, which is of course on the again XY line or on HP, and project O dash, here O, you will get O dash. Now if you observe, 0.3 is away from the observer, it's because the observer is observing from this side, 0.3 is away from the observer. So the lines related to 3 will be dotted lines. So if you observe here, 3O, 3-2 and 3-1 are the dot, should be the dotted lines. But if you observe here, 3-2 or 2-3 dash is the base on which it is resting. So you can't draw 3-2 dash as a dotted line. Again 3-1, though it is not visible from here, but 3-1 is a peripheral line of the tetrahedron view. So you also can't draw the line 3-1 as a dotted line. So what we have understood from here? Pause the video and think over it. See, though we need to draw 3-1 and 3-2 as a dotted line, we are not drawing. Why? So it is clear from here that the peripheral lines must not be dotted, those are not visible. So we will not be drawing 3-1 and 3-2 as dotted line, but 3-0 can be a dotted line. So project 3 upwards, as I told you, 3-2-1. So 1-3-2, you will get. So join the points 1-2 as a dark line, because it is visible from here. Join 1-3, though it must have been dotted line, but as it is a peripheral line, we will draw this as a dark line. And 2-3 is again a peripheral line which is resting on HP. So 2-3 also will be a dark line. So 1-2, 2-3, and 3-1 will be dark lines. Now join 1-0, of course that is visible, clear, and 2-0, that is 2-0, of course is a visible line. Only the line is a dotted line is O-3. So complete the view, and this will give you the final view where the tetrahedron 45 sides and the edge, the face is making 45 perpendicular to HP, and the base is inclined at 45 degree to VP. So here we have made the face perpendicular to HP, and here we have made base 45 degree to VP. As this is a point view, this will be a true length line. So this also will be a true length line. So need not to go for apparent length or true length here. So it will be, of course, a true length line. Project it upwards and complete. For this, we have used engineering drawing by P.H. Chain. Thank you.